Congratulations. Congratulations, see what the Lord has done for you. Congratulations.
Time for jubilation. Congratulations.
Hi guys, it's a beautiful evening. Doom. The sun is setting, and honestly I love the view in this place. Today I'll be sharing with you guys my wedding video, so I said why not come and take it in such a beautiful scenery. So green, the clouds are clear. Just look at that, the beauty. Look at that, look at that, look at that. Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your girl Sarah, and I'm coming right from Uganda, Africa. And today this video is going to be very exciting because I'll be sharing with you guys about my wedding video. I know you've been waiting for it for so long, but today I'm finally sharing with you guys the part one of my wedding video. So it all started, like, we decided in the morning after the day, if you saw in our previous video of our customary marriage, then we decided that we were going to do a wedding, but not in church. We decided that in the same reception is where we shall make our vows. So I just want you to grab your popcorns, sit down. But please, if you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. Kindly, please, please, please subscribe. And don't forget to leave a comment down below so that we get to know what you're exactly thinking. And share these videos with friends. Please enjoy the video. This is part one, and be sure to watch the part two of the wedding video. Since the video is quite very long, we shall be making it in 2-3 parts. But I hope you enjoy it very well. Thank you guys. I love you so much. Bye bye.
Can you see what the Lord has done? What we waited for has come to pass. See what the Lord has done.
On your wedding day, you're gonna sing that.
Can you see what the Lord has done?
When you walk into that property,
can you see what the Lord has?
When that healing happens,
what we've been praying for, He has brought to pass. See what the Lord has done.
Someone. Say,
see what the Lord has done.
Can you see?
See what the Lord has done. What we've waited for.
say, my eyes have seen, my ears have heard. I have seen what the Lord has done. But baby, I've been waiting for, he has brought it to pass. Hey!
This year was one of the most emotional moments for us in the wedding day. I was happy and sad at the same time, because honestly we were not able to invite each other to our wedding. Our friends and family, Edward's family was not here, and most of my family was not here. So I was happy and sad at the same time. But everything was going quite well with the wedding. But
and worship team to give us two, three songs of worship and praise. And then after we will invite our pastor who will give us a word. And then we will continue in terms of praise and worship. And then we will continue. Let me invite DJ.
There is something today in the house of the Lord.
There is something today in the house of the Lord. There is something today in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah, today in the house of the Lord.
Thank you.
we thank you and we bless your name in the mighty name of Christ our Lord. Amen.
And everyone says,
amen.
Yes. Like our pastor to give us, to take us in the next session.
God,
amen.
It is a great
thing.
I thank God for this day, and I thank all of you who have enabled me to come this day. You have asked Sarah and Edward's prayer today, that you have not let them down. I thank God for the good weather.
Has given us a good weather.
And
I really feel good that we are in a good atmosphere. And feel at peace where you are. When the rain began, I didn't fear. Because I know our God is a good God.
And God forgive
for
this good.
I
to ensure you that this is of God that is being
done.
I want to honor God and to humble myself
before
and to help me to understand Him more than I've been understanding Him. We are going in a great time. Praise be to God. I asked his father where he said
it.
Is the brother there? Yes, he is
a brother.
The brother-in-law is here around. Yes, he's around.
Mama, mama, wali,
is
around.
Is the mother present? Yes, she is.
They
given her to be in this marriage. Yes, they
are.
And I shall also ask you
now.
You're all going to answer that. If not, then we should know what that we shouldn't go forward.
Praise
God. Let us go to the scriptures. Genesis chapter 2. Verse 18.
Anybody
with a Bible? In
English Bible.
And the Lord said, it is not good that a man should be alone. I will make for him a helper comparable to him.
Mukama yebaziwe. Tuwe na kusomega wani kwa bena tu bimaleyo. Amen?
We're going to read the scripture.
Katisomane First Corinthians 7:2.
First Corinthians 7:2. Nevertheless, because of sexual immorality, let each man have his own wife and let each woman have her own husband.
Hallelujah!
So it is of God.
Mukama yebaziwe. Okubera abafungo. Okubera omwami n'omukyala. Mukama yebaziwe. Otusomereko ne mu Matayo. Ne mu Matayo esula. Matayo esula ye 19 5 mpaka ku mukaga.
Matthew 19, verse 5 to 6 says. And said, for this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife.
Uh-huh.
The two shall become one flesh.
Uh-huh.
So then they are no longer two but one flesh. Uh-huh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate.
Uh-huh. Then Mark 10:8-9.
Mark 10:8-9 says, and the two shall become one flesh, so they are no longer two but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate.
Hallelujah. Katula wa watu wabili wano.
We see two people.
Tulaba Edward Pasel.
We see Edward
Pasel. Netulaba nina Nyamugenya Sara.
We see Nyamugenya Sara.
Katula kendo kufuko mtu omu.
We are going to become one flesh.
Edward.
All of you here, you are
testing,
you are witnessing. To confirm the word of God. We walk in the word. We don't want to go out of the word. And today, Sarah and Edward. The
moves
that you're going to make. They are going to make you one person. And God is going to make you powerful. Because Edward has been weak. Your power is in Sarah. Even Sarah has been weak. So her power is in Edward. After this marriage, you're going to see these people powerful. What God put in
Sarah.
Because Edward has been weak. head.
Because
the husband is the head.
The
wife is the other part. Everyone, you would not get out of your place because you didn't have the leg. You didn't have the hand. God has joined you to bring up a divine purpose. The great work that is going to be done in your life. So God is going to sit and do something new. What I'm saying is this. This is how God operates. God prepared. He doesn't have to worry about today. This is not a mistake. This is not a mistake.
This is not a mistake.
I believe that Edward came from his country not intended of
it.
I remember Saul lost
his father.
The father to Saul lost his donkey. Now they went to look for those donkeys. So when that donkey got lost, it was the will of God that Saul may go where he is to find Samuel to anoint him to become king.
Hallelujah!
Amen. For Edward to look for Sarah as his friend. It was a
journey
of God to make God enter into your relationship.
Hallelujah!
To enter into your inheritance.
Congregation,
what are you?
What are you?
What are you?
What are you?
generation that is against their wedding,
then no, be together. No, not at all.
If there is nobody, then they should keep quiet for the rest of their lives. So the father is going to give
So you are going to walk together.
Because she has been faithful to the family, God has been preparing her.
all the tears you're seeing, it is because Sarah is a good girl. And I believe God has joined you that you only add value on what she has been doing. May God bless you. So we are going in the time of wedding. I prayed for them in the morning. I anointed them. And I dedicated them in the blood. I prayed that these rings are special from other rings. Holy matrimony. As the physical of the covenant that has been made. As a sign of the love of God. And everybody is going to make vows as using these rings as a physical sign. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. It is the time for exchanging vows. Sarah is going to make her vows to her husband.
Gamba nti. Nze Sarah Nyamugenya.
I Sarah Nyamugenya.
Olunaku olwalero.
Today.
Nsazewo.
I have decided.
We mwami Pastel. Pastel.
And you, Edward.
Okubeera omwami wange okutandika na leero okubeera omwami wange nkuwa ebyange byonna eby'omu nsi sigenda kukyawa mu bulungi bwonna ne mu bubi bwonna ogenda kusigala ng'oli mwami wange era okufa kwe kumutwawukanya nteekako empeta eno ng'akabonero ak'okugulu ak'okugulu akakakasa ekiri munda mu nze nti bwe wekka gwe nnonze mu bangi obululu ne nga we bagamba nti nno kyewagatta awamu tewali akigattulula Sarah amaze okwogera ebirayiro bye era nange nyweza ebirayiro lino mu linnya erya kitaffe n'omwana n'omwoyo omutukuvu okuva olunaku olwaleero
From today, I take you as my wife. I take you as my wife. I give you all my life.
I give you all my life.
And
my body.
And my body.
To be my wife.
To be my
wife.
From today.
From today.
And I'm putting
this ring. And I put this ring.
And I put this ring.
From today.
From today.
That you are
my wife. That you are
my wife.
That you are my wife.
Sigenda kuchawa.
I'll not leave you.
I'll not leave you.
Okufa kwe mduli twawukanya.
Death shall put us apart.
Death shall put us apart.
Amen. Obugale.
Do what you want to do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I start today on behalf of our late mother, the late Akelo Airi. I stand here as her heir. I'm glad to witness this marriage. Father, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, this is the day that you have made. It is a day that you wrote in your book even before we were born. It is a day that for you already knew this calendar, this date, you knew its time and the moment that it will come. Thanks for fulfilling it. Thanks for making it to pass. It has been long what we have been waiting for. Thank you, God, for giving us this miracle after a 3 days fasting of dry. And we believed in you and you answered us within 2 weeks. I glorify your name. I pray for these people a long-lasting marriage. They are going to see their gray hair. They will see their grandchildren. In that book of Isaiah where you tell us that people will see their gray hair, they will grow old with each other. They will always understand one another. I declare your blessings of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob and all these people. Bless them financially. Bless them in the children they will give birth to. Bless them in the generations to come home, that they will see you and glorify your name. They will testify, Edward and Sarah, their love story has been a great love story. For Jesus' mighty name I pray.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I'm so delighted that Sarah and Edward, after courtship of about 3 years,
formed
today, and I'm delighted that made up their mind to become a husband and wife. I'm sorry, my wife is with you, but they have my blessing.
Bless them with everything.
I bless them with everything, children, good life. So I thank God for that.
Thank you.
so much. Let me request Brother George to add us another.
takes me back home.
Yes, I'm feeling
what
bad.
Do I do? So me tell her say my bad boy, I'm not tired to look good.
I am not feeling so bad boy.
Her, no scratches, no work. I hope you'll be the best husband you have promised. Today, I want to confirm that I've given to you my daughter as your legal wife. I don't have much to say. My only prayer is may God bless the two of you and have meaningful life in your relationship. Thank you.
Yes, now we're going to welcome the mother. Then after that, we'll have a friend. A friend to come and talk something. Let us clap for the mom.
Praise the living God. Hallelujah. Listen, it's broken. In your mother, Bernard, it's a family. It's a big change. Sarah, you're opened a gate. Sarah and Eva, you've opened a big entrance to us. Where you people have gone is where we are going to follow.
Amen.
In the kingdom of God, it doesn't matter who comes first. I have known Sarah from when she was born. From the first day they gave birth to her is when I've known her. I was privileged to take the space of our mother when she died. Even when her body was still laid there, the late mother, that's when those kids started calling me Ma. It disappeared when they grew up a bit, and again, when they are now completely grown and married, they call me Ma. I'm honored to be a mother at my age, and I'm honored to give Sarah. I'm honored that Sarah has been, she has been actually not a sister, she has been my daughter, my best friend, my confidence.
Amen.
She's my decision maker.
Amen.
She knows it. I can't do anything. Time had come, which was bad maybe in the kingdom of God, but I'd nicknamed that we were more of husband and wife. We share the same bed, same clothes, same perfume, same jelly, everything. We use one. Indeed, as Rogers has shed the tears, it's like Edward, you're taking away somebody very important. Sarah is the last child in my mother and father, but she has been playing a role of a firstborn child. She has been playing a role as a first child. What our firstborn would be doing, or me, her elder sister, and the mother, is what she has been doing. Today, on your day, I will tell you that congratulations. Congratulations to my best friend, to my darling, to my lovely baby. I'm glad. I welcome you to the world of the married life, my sister. As you begin your life together with your new husband, I want you to know that I am here for you. If you ever need anything, you are important to me. Very important. I'm not giving you out because you've lacked space in our family. We love you. So, I give you and I love you and I wish both of you the best of the now and the future to come. May you have that long, long life. I hope that your life together will be filled with every blessing that you are happy together. Congratulations, Edward. I love you all.
Yes, let us clap for Mama Maureen for that wonderful speech. Yes, and next now, we want a friend to come and give some words that are concerning the two.
Yes, yes, we. Sijja kwogera ng'omutwe gwange teguliiko.
You interpret it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sarah, you have your mutwe.
Mother says, Sarah, God, and I also have my head. This one is my head.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sarah, congratulations.
Sarah, congratulations.
I love you so much.
Kwangala nyo.
Ed, we love you so much.
Edward, we love you so much.
Bana isimani wa itandikira.
I don't know where to start from.
Atete mani wa ngendo kuma.
I don't know where I will end.
Yesu yeziwe.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Ndi mwenyankole weri.
I'm a mwenyankole.
Na fumi wa mteso weri.
I married a mteso.
Na iba nai kati. Feturi wa dama.
Now for us we are dama.
That is my girl. What way put it?
Smiley. It's the way I'm feeling.
When I cover the Mugamba to
cry, don't wonder.
Sarah, man, I'm too.
Sarah is young.
Never when put it as Sarah,
but there's a way at a certain point. Place that I feel sad in my heart. I entered in family Sarah. I found my husband was a friend to Mami
Mori.
And Mori got me from my family, my home.
Daddy
Mori took me from Bunyankole.
Yes,
that's why I'm Mudama.
Yes, we have us.
Hallelujah. I entered here. I joined their family. From Sarah, the last born to the oldest. I'm also their sister. Sibling. I thank God for Sarah.
Mama.
She has stood for us. She's young. But if there is anything, situation, a problem, there is this word she usually tells me, and I feel my life is
all
Sarah, we love you. You have done a lot in my marriage. You have done great. Sarah doesn't know my home origin. Amen. Sarah has reached where even my siblings couldn't reach. Even where they won't reach. Praise the name of Jesus.
Last COVID, second wave.
The last COVID in the second wave. COVID-19.
First wave.
The first wave. I lost my parents at once. I was one and alone in this world. They couldn't allow people to move. No one could move, total lockdown. I don't know how Sarah walked from Butcho to
Kasoko.
When I looked at her, it's like at
my family. He's
too young. But when I saw Sarah, I had a heartfelt feeling. I'm happy for today. I've prayed for this day for 3 years. I've fasted for 3 years. We reached a time and I told Sarah, we are
Sarah.
I told her,
tusabye,
we have prayed,
tusibye,
we have fasted,
tukoze buli kimu,
we have done everything.
Ebisigadde tubirekeka.
Let us leave the rest unto the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Katonda ayina ebiro bye n'ebiseera.
God has the seasons of time.
Sarah, ebiseera bituuse.
Sarah, this is at the season.
Era nkwaniriza mu Bufumbo Institute.
And I welcome you in the Bufumbo Institute.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I'm glad, I'm happy. I've been crying by tears of joy. You may think I'm the one going abroad. Praise Jesus. I wish you good, Sarah. You have brought with my siblings. You have left us with young
girl.
But we pray for you. God bless you. Bless you with children. Bless you with friends. Wherever you go, that's where you get new parents. Where you go,
sisters and brothers.
About Uganda. As I left there and I met you this side, don't worry of the color and the rest. I didn't care, I was a Munyankole, now I'm a Mudamu.
Yes, we have as the
Sarah, God bless you.
Let him
for you great and mighty things.
And
your husband, let him give you good children. And boys and girls. And the twins also. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs.
Proverbs 17:17.
Proverbs chapter 17, verses 17. One verse. That the friend of a person loves them in the bad times and even in the good times. They are there. Sarah, you have been there in the bad times. You have been there in the happy times. Something I've forgotten. Let me speak. I was in tears so deep when I just given birth.
Mama wange jata mani.
My father doesn't know.
Baganda wange wata mani.
My siblings don't know.
Nagendo kuchusa maso nga Sara aliteso.
To open my eyes, Sarah was in tears so deep in the village.
Nangamba nsise.
She told me I've come.
Banae Sara.
Sarah.
Katondo oyo womuguru.
The God in heaven. That I'm serving for 17 years now. As I'm standing, let him bless you. Let him give you your heart desire. He has given you holy
marriages
and you've opened doors. Make you a strong man of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sarah,
God bless you. The rest of the people.
Roger. Mommy Maureen.
Mom Mori.
Beatrice.
Mom. Please come to Kasokoso. Come and visit me. Even if I go to Teso, please come. I also come. You're my sibling. One day we shall go to
I thank God for Sarah's life. I thank God for Sarah and the relationship between Sarah and my wife. They have come from far. They have come from very far, whereby even if I'm to start to explain where they have come from, I may finish the whole evening. So I don't have much to say, but I wish Sarah a successful marriage. May God bless you, bless the husband, and bless the children whom you are going to produce.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let us clap for them. The words are many that have been spoken, but they are true. I myself, for the little time I've seen Sarah, she has been a good child. Sarah has loved me with the entire family. I remember they met me the last COVID.
They entered
in the church and we started being together. I've seen them to be good children of love. Praise God. One thing I've learned from Sarah is the love of Christ. God is good. When I reach there, I take a breath because it is exceedingly
surprising.
When I saw Sarah being happy in what she's doing, but I was surprised at what she is. What surprises me is the way she loves her and the way she loves children. She loves children even when their parents are there, and loves them more than the parents. If you want to annoy Sarah, touch the children. There is a day we are sleeping, like we spent the night in church in COVID praying. The whole week we were praying. We had a Nigerian woman. We used to pray with her. We used to pray for Edward's. But one day, we ask her that if Edward marries you, what will you do to the children? She said the man to marry me must be able to accept my children. The Nigerian woman told her that you're stupid. In your knowledge, have you ever seen a man who can marry you with the children and not yours? You must think wise. You must be put in your position. If someone takes you as you are. Sarah got a handkerchief and cried. After the woman going, I told Sarah, it's calling upon our lives, no one can understand it. But I request you empower yourself again. If that's what you want, that's the same thing God will do for you. Because God will do it. I learned and understood Sarah. Sarah doesn't want children only. Love the church also. I've been looking at her ever since we started praying. She used to buy the water for the pastors. Even when she's in a bad situation or she didn't have money, she used to buy. I've always been praying for Sarah. She didn't know that I was following her. I thank God for today, for what the Lord has done for Sarah, and I thank God for Edward. When I looked at the heart of Sarah and that heart of the Edward, I realized that Edward had the same heart as Sarah. And the courtship they had for like 4.5 years. When Edward is taking care of
Sarah,
Edward was taking care of the
family,
and they have been in good life. Amen. I really saw that Edward had accepted
Sarah.
The family of Sarah, I encourage you. If he has been taking her even before he had married her officially, now after you agreeing, it will be more.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mukama mulungi.
Amen. There is a day that came.
Nengamba Sara.
I told Sarah.
Umaze okulokoka.
You are born again.
Kakati kyolina okukola.
Now you have to do.
Kwe kuleka obwenzi.
Is to leave fornication.
Kubanga oyo musajja atakuwasanga mu butongole.
Because the man has not yet married you.
Kati olina okumuleka okukkiriza Katonda.
You have to leave her and accept God and believe God.
Nzijukira olunaku olwo Sara lwamubeerera luzibu.
That day was too hard for her. She told me, Mommy, what can I do? I told her, decide once.
Or to choose one.
Follow Jesus when you're clean.
Or
for Edward to be your God.
Sarah
took a step.
Talked
to the husband. The husband said these words. He said that even if you don't marry me, I will love you as you are. And I will continue doing what I was doing. That makes me confirm that the God in Edward is the same in Sarah. Because they are not doing for profit, but they are doing for the love of Christ. And I pray for you that to be great, you join the love you have. Let God do something great in your life. I pray for you that you be great. As a pastor, I've already seen that God is taking you far. And I don't have any complaints. Because I'm a person who loves good life for Sarah. I've seen pastors not wanting good for them. When the sheep is about to go, they put something to blow. But I wish good for her. Even if she go to Irish, she will be my child and I will love her. And I know where Sarah lives. Many people will be happy. And my happiness is when you
married.
When they are in the same house with Edward. When there is no distance in between. Maybe Edward can come to Uganda. Now that they are together. He's also Ugandan.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Because he has that right of citizenship.
Hallelujah. Amen.
It is upon him. They are in their season. He may decide, let me go and be with Sarah in Uganda. Or Sarah can decide to go with him. Because the Bible says that what you put together, no one can separate. Not even the company can separate. Doesn't have a right to separate
man.
Hallelujah. I end by saying, the God that gave me twins, let
you
meet
new
twins today
night.
Amen. Let him give you many children. Let God give you children for generation.
I want to start by thanking everyone. Like all of you who have taken your time to come and celebrate with us this beautiful moment in our lives. I want to thank the friends. And I want to give a special thanks to our pastors, especially Nami, because you guided us spiritually. Your counsel does. So grateful. So thank you so much. Thank you, Pastor Eva, for running around, down, up and down. All of you that have given your entire week to us, we're so grateful. Thank you for the friends that have come short notice. And I want to give a special thanks to my dad.
because honestly everything was depending on him, my dad and my brothers. I'm so grateful to be called your daughter. And I thank you for the decision that you made just for the sake of my happiness. I don't know what to say. I'm just so thankful to you, everyone. Beatrice, Maureen, Rodan, Nelly, thank you for coming. I also say a special thanks to my friends. I know many that I expected didn't come, but I'm so grateful for all of you. I'm so thankful to my girls. The young boys, all of you, thank you, thank you for coming. Honestly, this time I look as small as it is. But ever since we started the journey of planning our marriage, you've seen that the enemy fights about marriage. As we are, it has been like one of the longest weeks for me of the year. Because like it has been sleepless. I don't know what to say, it has been long. And I want to give a special thanks to you, Edward. I know I said thank you so many times, but I know it can never be enough. I want to say thank you for loving me. But before even loving me, thank you for loving my family, which is very important to me. Thank you for accepting me with the girls that are really part of my life. Thank you for sacrificing every single penny that you send out here for us to have a good life. Thank you for every sacrifice that you made. I know I'm not the best kind of a person. Maybe we have not had a great understanding, like we're not bad enough to communicate with each other. So. But I'm thankful that you're in my life. I'm so thankful to you and your family. I thank you that even in our hardest days when you're pretty mad like me, at least you don't pay to send me at this hello. And I also want to thank you that for all the times when we got the misunderstanding and you said that you break up, you never changed from calling me and you know, it was the darkest time because I spent over 6 months and you also accused me for not even smiling at you, but you gave this time, honestly, I didn't know that you were going to be able to reconcile. Because when my strength, honestly, it was the time I gave up. Though I loved you so much, I really also wanted to follow my path with Christ. That is very important to me now. I'm so thankful that you received Jesus Christ in your life. I know the journey we have started is not the easiest because we've all never been able to be together for a long time. And we might plan each other's behaviors that maybe we might not like, honestly. But I pray that even in our darkest time we can work it out. Pray together and be able to compromise with one another and be able to forgive each other and learn to live. What we have been seeing today, I think, is one of the lifetime things that we are not doing. But I know God will make it easier, though many people say it's hard, but I know God will make it easier. God will be strength easier for us and we shall go through it. And lastly, I'm going to again once more thank each and every one of you. My friend with the camera, Eddie, I know it was a short notice. Still last night, we did not get the aid to come here. He's one of our friends from our former church, and I'm glad for everyone. Betty, who has done my makeup and did every decoration. My gown that I did not plan for, and I got a gown this morning. I can't say thank you enough. Abby, the organizer, she has not just been an event organizer, but she has been so patient with me because today I was breaking down every single moment. Like I'm seeing rain, I'm seeing time is going. Like we didn't have a gown yesterday, we showed that maybe it is just a simple one, let's not get a gown. But then she went out in the rain and bought me a gown that we did not need to buy. And I'm so thankful because we didn't think of any entertainment. But Joy, thank you for your time that you have given. Thank you to Derek, all of me, that is your time, I know. I'm just so grateful and I pray that God bless you all.
Thank you, Sarah. Now, next member.
Praise God. How my family feels about the three girls. If they don't get a good quality of life and a good education, I might as well stay in Uganda because I can't go back to my family. With how my family feel about Sarah, I don't think I could ever bring any other woman home that my family would respect and admire as much as my family respects and admires Sarah. My family loves Sarah and my family loves Sarah. I put it on Facebook about a week ago that I was getting married, and I talked to pretty much everybody on my Facebook about Sarah, and everybody likes her. A lot of my friends follow her on YouTube, and everybody was very happy. All of my friends and my family are overjoyed that Sarah and I have reconciled and now we're married. I love Sarah very much. We've been chatting for a couple of days and I realized that she speaks six or seven languages, and that was when I decided to take her seriously as a partner. And I didn't fall in love with a millionaire, you know. One guy at home, and his wife's worth about 8 billion shillings, and he talks about the fact that he doesn't have to spend money on it, you know. Could I be having an interesting conversation with him? But I fell in love with a woman who worked 80 hours a week to put children through school, and I got to do everything that I can to make sure that she's a successful businesswoman, successful on YouTube. And I got to do everything I can to see these children get a university education. That's what my family wants, and that's what I love.
For Pastor Daniel, for Edward, and Sarah, and Sarah's family.
800, 500, 11, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 2, 1, and 0. Amen. Bless the Lord. DJ Musa. Hallelujah.
with love as a sign of celebration. Okay, Edward, now you can feed Sarah. Let us clap. Now he's going to give her something to drink. Sarah, what are you doing? Okay, Sarah, you can give her. Sarah is going to give you your portion from there. Sarah, you're going to give your husband the first meal you're prepared. And I hope to be so delicious. So Sarah, pick a fresh piece that we can take. Edward, they are going to pick. Now, something to drink. Oh, Ugaro. Wow, you blessed the Lord. Okay, thank you so much. Now, the bride and the bridegroom are going to give the father the cake. And they are going to give him the cake that is going to have. First, they are feeding the father. Meaning is a sign of respect in African culture. We bless God for that. Wow. Giving father is a blessing. Okay. Thank you so much. Now to the mother. Now to the mother. Mama Katereko Kariyeri is not something to do. Wow, bless God. Mama Mori, thank you for raising the child. May God bless you so much. Obugaro, those were in faith. Wow. Okay, now our brides are going to, bride and bridegroom are going to...
Yeah, don't. higher bus. I don't love a barber. African barber. Ebya mazina kuzina nga ganyuma bali abalala byo bazina zebimbo kanamba kunze matoke mba dance wana yente simanyo wansubolo kukafuna yeah, a smartphone Samsung zikuwa kapuza kafana nyi selfie kwa kubye me love you when you put it on me, you put it on me your body soft, girl ulinga balunia holy romantic kuza research buli musajja mukibuga kuli nako crash sibali mafachi pasto ba achi bonna bagala kukebera rizati give me your number to kwata gane give me your number go to kola gane give me your number to kwata gane give me your number girl aya bas to connect connect connecting aya to connect connect connecting to connect connect connecting aya to connect connect love you nzo swagala manya bali abalala bala bagala chitambulira chimanyi bagala nkute bakunemesa bala bebona bali mpoba guno mkwano gweni na jeriagulina jeriagulina bobona befela na zino sente zeni na jeriazirina yali azirina yagenda merifa aya kati ulirize vyange bikungu tenga kungu jobulu aya I know your ex wa mugambe ntikali anzo bido 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 yeah yeah mbona ya baby na yate akasente don't worry yeah 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 give me your number to kwata gane give me your number go to kola gane give me your number to kwata gane give me your number girl aya bas to connect connect connecting aya to connect connect connecting to connect connect connecting aya to connect love you mzimba ku love you you will kwa kamba ku love you my girl miss you nambi love you yo vi kwe kambambi love you my girl okay to banga ba china vimpe more bigino july na oh let me be your farmer nsobolo kukukabalira nga every day because kuno mkwano kweni na tiriagulina bobona befeda na zino sente zeni na tiriazirina Yaliazirina yagenda America give me your number to kwata gane give me your number go to kola gane give me your number to kwata gane give me your number girl aya bas to connect connect connecting aya to connect connect connecting to connect connect connecting aya to connect love you
watching my video, and don't forget to leave a thumbs up and a comment down below. Be sure to watch our next video. Love you guys. Bye bye.